Hello, everyone. Welcome to another week of your questions being answered. Thank you to everyone who's submitted questions through the newsletter. I continue to read every single last one of them. I just don't have time to respond. I've chosen a couple of them for this week's newsletter, and I'm going to get right to it. Are there more people like me called lightworkers, and what is our role on Earth now? And that was sent in by Lubica. Hopefully I'm saying these names right. So in terms of what lightworkers are, I think the first thing I'd have to clarify is, what do you term lightworker? In general terms, it means someone that is here to spread enrichment through enlightenment and spirituality to those that are around them. That's a lightworker. Someone who is in service to others and the earth, that's a lightworker. And what I would say is that it is clear that every single year we're seeing more and more and more people stepping into positions of being in service to others and wanting to serve humanity and wanting to serve our beautiful planet in a positive way so that we can have a really great future together. And so the question is, what is the role that everyone has? It's entirely different from individual to individual. For example, one person's role may be to work in a corporate structure, make a lot of money, and then take their position and maybe their influence and their finances, and maybe they're putting it towards passion projects of their own in their communities. That's a light worker. I think that people have got it stuck in their heads that a light worker fits into this box, and that's not the case. And then others, it may be to literally start speaking to the public about their own experiences that they've had or their own spirituality. But not everyone is meant to go out into the public and do that. Being a light worker is simply about being in service to others and being in service to the earth. And we have to find that for ourselves. So that I hope that that at least gives a little bit of an understanding that I can't answer that question for you, because we'd have to sit down together and have a really big conversation about it and assist you in finding your own answers to that. Because if somebody else tells you what your role is, you never fully accept it. And that's something that's really important to always remember. So another question here is, what's the story on the object that was buried in the backyard to be retrieved at a certain time? So any of you who have read my book, Blue Star Fulfilling Prophecy, which if you haven't received a copy for the download PDF version, you would have seen it when you first signed up for the newsletter. And you can also get the book online on Amazon.com or wherever you happen to be. And what they're referring to here is something that the extraterrestrials gave to me and I buried it. No, it has not been found. I tried to look for it a number of times, but unfortunately what happened was there was a really old building that was, I think, it burnt down. I'm not sure. And then a bulldozer came and pushed all of the debris around. So in order for me to go there and excavate it, I would have to pay probably tens of thousands of dollars in order to do that and get permission from the people whose land that it is. So no, it has not been retrieved, unfortunately. So those are a couple of small questions for today. I don't want to make these videos too long. I just wanted you to know how grateful I am for all of the questions that you're sending in. And as the newsletter gets started, we're hoping to be able to put them all in one place so you'd be able to go back and watch these videos and read more of the answers and insight that I'll be sharing through it. And also, I think that what I'm seeing, I'll leave it at this, is that what I'm seeing is the general storyline of questioning that people are sending in is about how to tap into their own spiritual power. And that is really, really, really important when we're talking about what these extraterrestrials gave to us as the greatest gift of all, which is the understanding that we are the most powerful technology on Earth. So until next week, please send in more questions and I will read every one of them. Thank you very much, everyone. Take care.